All right, Shalom Akyam. This is the third installment of Esau's prison system, and I'm just going to start off with the scripture Psalms 119 and 15. Excuse me, Psalms 119 and 10. The wicked have laid a snare for me, yet I erred not from thy precepts. But what are one of the snares that Esau laid? Esau being the wicked, he laid the snare of the prison system complex because it's structured to bait in the 12 tribes into the penitentiary. One of the main snares he uses within the prison system complex is the drug game, because the drug game is structured off poverty. And the algorithm or the setup is, if you're poor, you have limited resources, you're going to be more tempted to hop in a drug game to feed yourself or your family, man. You might be underage or whatever it may be. You couldn't go through the public school system, which is garbage, all right? And it's not to justify it, but You're more likely to do it if you live in poverty. But part of Esau's prison system complex is targeted at the poor, not the evil, not criminals, but the poor. All right. But without further ado, I'm going to jump into the article. This is number 21, as far as the 21st reason, the so-called blacks and Latinos on the prison system. 21. Lots of poor people plead guilty. Lack of adequate public defense leads many people in prison to plead guilty. The American Bar Association reviewed the U.S. public defender system and concluded it lacked fundamental fairness and put poor people at constant risk of wrongful conviction. 22. Many are forced to plead guilty. Consider all the exonerations of people who were forced by police to confess even when they did not do the crime, who were later proven innocent. Some criminologists estimate 2 to 8% of the people in prison are innocent but plead guilty. One longtime federal judge estimates that there is so much pressure on people to plead guilty that there may easily be 20,000 people in prison for crimes they did not commit. 23. Almost nobody in prison ever had a trial. Trials are rare in the criminal justice system. Over 95% of criminal cases are finished by plea bargains. In 1980, nearly 20% of criminal cases were tried, but that number is reduced to less than 3% because sentences are now so much higher for those who lose trial. There are more punishing drug laws, mandatory minimum sentences, and more power has been given to prosecutors. Number 24, poor people get jail, and jail makes people worse off. The poorest people, those who had to remain in jail since their arrest, were four times more likely to receive a prison sentence than those who got out on bail. There are tens of thousands of rapes inside jails and prisons each year. DOJ, Department of Justice, reports over 4,000 inmates are murdered each year inside each year. As U.S. Supreme Court Justice Kennedy told Congress recently, this idea of total incarceration just isn't working, and it's not humane. We, society, and Congress and the legal profession have no interest in corrections. Nobody looks at it. 25. Average prison sentences are much longer than they used to be, especially for people of color. Since 1990, the average time for property crime has gone up 24%. And time for drug crime has gone up 36%. In the U.S. federal system, nearly 75% of the people sent to prison for drug offenses are black or Latino. 26. There is about 70% chance that an African-American man without a high school diploma will be in prison by the time he reaches his mid-30s. The rate for white males without a high school diploma is 53% lower. In the 1980, there was only an 8% difference. In New York City, for example, blacks are jailed at nearly 12 times the rate of whites, and Latinos more than 5 times the rate of whites. All right. So basically, you can see the difference between how long Esau was in prison and how long Jake is in prison. Number 27. Almost 1 of 12 black men ages 25 to 54 are in jail or prison, compared to 1 in 60 non-black men. That is 600,000 African-American men are in prison. That is 600,000 African-American men, an imprisonment rate of 5 times that of white men. So Jake is, there are 5 times more Israelites in jail than so-called so-called white men. 5 times more, all right? 28, prison has become a very big private business. Corrections Corporations of America owns and runs 67 for-profit jails in 20 states with over 90,000 beds. Along with GEO, these two private prison companies have donated more than $10 million to candidates and spent another $25 million lobbying, according to the Washington Post. They lobby all over the country and over the past 10 years have doubled the number of prisoners they hold. 29. The Sentencing Project reports that over 159,000 people are serving life sentences in the U.S. Nearly half are African American and 1 in 6 are Latino. The number of people serving life in prison has gone up by more than 400% since 1984. Nearly 250,000 prisoners in the U.S. are over age 50. Number 30. Inside prisons, the poorest people are taken advantage of, again, as most items such as telephone calls to families are priced exorbitantly high, some as high as $12.95 for a 15-minute call, further separating families. I'm going to go back to number 29. It says the Sentencing Project reports that over 159,000 people are serving life sentences in the U.S., nearly half are African American and 1 in 6 are Latino. The number of people serving life in prison has gone up by more than 400% since 1984. Nearly 250,000 prisoners in the U.S. are over age 50. And that rings a bell because that's when they started cracking down those drug laws during the 1980s. So if you had a guy that got locked up in the 1980s that was in his 20s, guess what? 30 years later, he's in his 50s. So that would make sense when number 29 is saying that nearly a quarter million prisoners in the U.S. are over age 50, man. Esau, he put his foot down back in the 80s during the crack era, man, when he gave us crack, then gave us harsh sentences for Jake that was caught with crack, all right? It's more severe to get caught with the ounces of crack than the kilos of coke, man, than the cocaine itself. All right, but that concludes the third installment. To the next installment, Shalom.